telling some of you right now, the Lord's going to be the start of new ministry.
Amen.
preaching on the theme, Step Out by Faith. However, as I said, I want to flesh out this theme as of today and chart it forth for the rest of the year by looking at some things about faith. So turn your Bibles to Hebrews chapter 11. Hebrews chapter 11. Hebrews chapter 11 verse 1 gives us the definition of faith. So that's the first thing I want us to know, the definition of faith. If you're going to step out by faith, you need to know what faith is. And Hebrews 11 verse 1 gives us the definition of faith. It's a very popular verse, but I'm not too sure at times if some Christians get it. Verse 1, and may I invite you to read with me again, you can be seated, just read this one verse with me. Let's go after 2, 1, 2. Now faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. The definition of faith. If you don't understand what faith is, or if you don't know how to define faith, turn persons to Hebrews chapter 11 verse 1. If you don't know how to explain it, turn them to Hebrews chapter 11 verse 1. Let's look at some words here. First of all, the word faith. The word faith here from the Greek is pistis. I'm almost afraid to pronounce that word in the pulpit, but that's, it's pistis. All right. I'm not cursing. That's what the word is, and it has different breakdowns, pisteo and so forth. So moving on from that Greek pronunciation, the word really means persuasion. It says faith is. Faith is persuasion. It's your moral conviction. It's your belief system. Faith is a moral conviction. It's a persuasion or a belief. Belief system or believing. So he said, faith is the substance. That word substance comes from a Greek word that means, get this, it literally means to sit under or support. Faith is the substance. Something that is going to support, to sit under. And then the word substance also means assurance. It also means confidence. Substance. It also means essence. I get this. It also means concrete. Faith is the concrete. What's going on here? I just felt like I lose some mind power here. Anybody heard the same thing? Alright, you hear me though? Alright, good. Faith is the substance, it is the setting under, the support, the assurance, the confidence, the concrete, or the essence. And it says here, of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. Amen. The Lord wanted me to walk around today. Alright, praise the Lord. Alright. It is the evidence of things not seen. I'd like to define one more word. I've defined faith, I've defined substance. Now let's define the word evidence as used in the Greek language. The word evidence means proof or conviction. Evidence means proof or conviction. So let's put that whole verse together. We're looking at the definition of faith. Let's put that whole verse together in our own words. What is this verse saying? Faith is confidence of things hoped for, but the proof of things that are not yet seen. Let me give you another one. Faith is a well-grounded assurance of that which we hope for or expect, while having a conviction of the reality of things we do not see. Let's put it even clearer than this. The idea of faith defined here is that we decide to place our faith and trust in something that we have no literal, tangible evidence to show people. In other words, let a lot of people talk about money and we need money. So for instance, you say, can I use the Hope Ministry for example, Brother Arvin? Alright, let me use the Hope Ministry for example. 2-3 years ago, we charted a course that we were going to go to Grenada on a mission trip in 2017. Let's look at that faith defined. As we made our plans, we had fundraisers, you guys helped us. But as 2017 came to a reality, and it came closer to the time for us to go to that greater trip, we began to realize that another reality hit us. We still didn't have enough money raised to go to Grenada. Here is where faith comes in. We had no evidence to show, let's say if we were to raise 10,000 US to go to Grenada, but we were $5,000 short. By the way, we were really short on that. Right, Sister Pat? We were short on that, what your friend argument said. $5,000 short. No. If you come and ask us where is the plan to get that money, we would say to you, our plan is in God. We don't have the evidence in our bank account. We don't have the finances to show you, but we know we are going to get the money to go to Grenada. That is what faith is. You don't have any evidence to show anybody anything. And that is why some people call it crazy faith. Because those who don't have faith will think that we are crazy. And I want to understand, I want to say this, if I don't say this for the rest of the year. There is nothing wrong with planning. We planned. That was the fundraiser. But our plan still fell short. No, this is where faith comes in. Lord, we have done our part. Faith is God. No, you do your part. We don't know where that comes from, but we know that you will bring it from. That is what faith is. Sometimes we're looking for evidence and proof of some things that, listen, what is going to happen? Who are you going to get there? You don't know who's going to get there, but you know that God is going to take you there. That's what faith is. And I'm not too sure that some Christians understand that. I said that you must plan if needs be, but there's a time when you just can't plan anymore. You must plan your life for what you want to do and so forth, but there's a time when plans will fail, or in other words, it will be insufficient. And that's when you turn to God. In fact, you turn to God even before, asking to direct your plans. And I tell you that God is a God who will sometimes just erase your plans to show himself strong. Because there are some of us who are planning all of our lives and planning to do some things that cannot come through. And will not come through because they're against God's plans. Faith is saying to people, saying to yourself, or saying to God that, Lord, I have the confidence that you are going to make this thing happen, even though I don't know the blueprint. Yes. That is faith defined. But then, the next two verses gives you the description of faith. Faith is defined in verse 1, the definition of faith. The next two verses give you the description of faith. It says here in verse 2, for by it, by what? Faith, the elders obtain a good report. Verse 3, through faith we understand that the worlds were framed by the word of God, so that things which are seen were not made of things which do appear. He uses two examples here. The writer uses the elders, their report, and also the creation of the world as a description of faith. Because when people define something, we want an example or illustration. He gives you two illustrations. Verse 2, he uses the elders. It means, what he's saying is that it was because of faith that the elders, meaning our ancestors, the forefathers, the patriarchs, the men of God, the men of renown, it was because of faith that they obtained a good testimony. They received God's approval. The ancient men of God lived by faith so that they obtained a good reputation. They were the ones who exercised it, and they understood exactly what it means to have faith. It's because of faith that these men, they got their reputation. There are times when we would have read in the scriptures, Old Testament and New, of the kind of faith that some of them had that showed this commitment to God and this confidence in God. I have said it to some of you at different points, that if some of these men and women of faith in the Bible didn't have 100% confidence in God, they would have embarrassed themselves. And I want to say this to you. Make sure you know what. Let me put it another way. Make sure you know that God is going to do the thing before you say the thing. Some of you look like you're lost. In other words, let me just make up something, because some of you're lost. The old brother said, God will part the sea. The mother road I'm going here, so don't know. And then you go make big statements and say, come on and come see the sea part. And when you go down there, you put up your hand and say, sea part. And see, still. I'm saying to you that the men and women of God had to have a confidence in God that he was going to do it. Because if he didn't do it, they would be embarrassed and also embarrassed to God, who they serve. So understand that faith is tied to who God is, and your faith and confidence in who God is. And I just want to be clear, you know, if I don't say it for the rest of the year, the kind of faith that pleases God is not 99% faith, you know, is 100% faith. That is why next week I'm going to talk about the 99% that you thought was enough to please God, and the 10%. Listen, when you're having this kind of faith in God, it has to be 100. This is what unlocks or unleashes God's power, you know. Don't get me wrong, he already has our power, but it is your faith that will unleash it. Can I go back to the home ministry, Brother Alvin? So when last year a time was drawing near, by permission I have, I told him at some point says, when time was drawing near, and it's supposed to be about 15 of us to go, and not all of us had our paid tickets yet. And fundraiser don't shut off long time. And I realized there was a little doubt. They're good people, but you know, good people doubt. And they were really doubting someone and said, we're not going to get y'all because we don't going to see the money yet, and the fundraiser, we're going to bring enough money. We said to myself, say, as the spiritual leader of the group ministry, I am going to have to call a meeting. And so we called a meeting. Remember, Sister Pat? And we called a meeting and I said, listen to me. And this is the pastor that turned into another one. I said, listen to me. We are not pleasing God if we don't.
Yes.
I'm saying, help me join in prayer and show God the 100% faith. And I said to them, listen, if you have 100% faith that God is going to release the money, you must first release your faith.
Yes.
And I said, watch it. It was a Friday, I'll never forget it. It was a Friday, and I said, release your faith and God will release the money. Watch it, word. It didn't take long. By the time everybody understands that they must believe 100%, and the hope is to say, let's believe God together. By Sunday, somebody came to me from overseas and said, we have a check for you. And I don't even know what was in the city yet. They have a check. Is there a ministry that we can donate this to? I know, I want to tell the story, buddy. Here I was, Sunday. You remember some of you who have been here for a while that used to have a banner over here, so? Going to Grenada. They called me and they were standing right underneath the banner. And they said, is there a ministry that we can donate this money to that you are praying about? And we said, Lord, you couldn't set yourself up better way. We said, yes, look up. We're going to Grenada and we shot a few thousand US dollars. And they said, let's not stand in the way of God, they're here. And they gave us that money. I couldn't contain myself. When we, you know, say, when we go out of the church, what's up? Blew up to the whole ministry. We said, we tell you no. Go book your ticket. In fact, I'm going to tell you all the story. Before even getting that check, the Sunday morning, private conversation now being made public. The Sunday morning before I came to church, I was in dialogue with the group leader and I said, listen, we don't know where to come from, which to come. You bring out some money that you are saving to keep for use the expenses to Grenada. I said, use the expense money and book the ticket. That will provide. We want to book the ticket for us. We show the way to go. When I got home, we said, you see? See here, you have expense money. Listen, that's what faith is all about. That is why I want to come on that journey with me. The faith that pleases God. Because the elders had that kind of faith. We need that kind of faith. Some of us will never see those kind of miracles because we don't have that kind of faith. We are the ones that are holding back some deliverances from God. Oh Lord, we're in for a good year now. So verse 3 says, through faith, we understand the worlds were framed by the word of God. He used a word here, framed. He didn't use the word created. He didn't use the word made. And of course, you know, God created the heaven, God made the heavens and the earth and all that. He uses a word that is different from the usual God created and God made. He uses framed, which means set in order, or arranged, or completed. Think of God as an architect, and it says, it is by faith that we believe that God set things in order. Let there be light. And there was light. But he didn't just fill up the sun and fill up the stars with his mouth, I should say. He didn't just say, God is up. He set it in order. That's what the word frame indicates. He framed it. He put this world in order. And it is running how he wants it to run. The galaxies, the whole system, it is running how God wants it to run. It is by faith that we accept and believe that God formed the world by speaking it into being, so that what is seen does not owe its existence to what which is visible, that which is visible. Look at the last part. Let me start from the top. Through faith we understand that the worlds were framed by the word of God. That word means not the Bible, it means the speech of God, the utterance of God. God formed, framed, created this world by saying, let there be light, and there was light. Let there be water, and there was water. Sometimes we even misapprehend theology to think that God created dirt with his hand. No, he spoke dirt into being. That's how great he is. Let there be dirt, and there was dirt, and from dirt he could form Adam and Eve. That's where he took on the hands-on approach, after he made the raw materials with his robes. How great is our God that he could just speak the sun into being, the seeds into being. What a God, and he does that in order. So that things which are seen were not made of things which do appear. Things which are visible are not made by things which already exist. Because, you know, some of you who know the studies behind evolution and so forth, God knew that sometime in the future, people were going to come up with all kinds of theories of how the world was created. One of them is evolution, about this Big Bang theory and molecules form and then people come from monkey and evolve into human beings. God knew that that was going to be an argument. So he put in there, Hebrews 11 verse 3 and the latter part. Who do you think he's talking to? And about the people who said that there was some molecule explosion and then the world just kind of formed itself. They were claiming that the world began out of something that existed before. And he said, no, not so. Our God created it. Our God framed it. Our God formed it. The world we see was not formed from any matter that just appeared. The world was not molded from pre-existing materials. It was formed out of nothing by God's speech, by God's word. There was nothing there before. God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit existed, and they never were born. They were always there. And one day, they said to themselves, let us make a world. And they did. So these are some descriptions of faith. And he says, we believe that. It has to be a belief, you know. It's either accepted or rejected. So that's faith described. But we want to move on. We have looked at the definition of faith. We have looked at the description of faith. Now let's look at the demonstration of faith. He then uses some examples. Noah and Abraham. I am skipping out Enoch and others for now, because just these two really match the idea of stepping out by faith. So I want us to go to verse 6 now. He was talking about Enoch in verse 5. Then he says in verse 6, but without faith, it is impossible to please him. Why? There are some things that are impossible. And this is what he says. This is a strong word, you know. That's why I say you need to get this. If you do not have that 100% faith, it is impossible. It is not possible. You cannot please God. We're going to talk about that faith as we go along this year. For he that cometh to God must believe that he is, meaning you must believe that God exists. So therefore, we already know that the people who call themselves atheists, who don't believe that there is a God, that God exists, they have no faith. And God has no pleasure in them. You remember when the Bible tells us not to call people fool, right? You remember that? Matthew.
Yes.
Chapter 5, I think. And he says, don't call people fool. God gives himself the authority to do that. And I'm showing you what I'm getting to. There's a psalm that says the fool has said in his heart, there is no God. God is telling us not to call people fool, but they choose to call some people fool. And one of them is the people who don't believe that there's a God. It is foolish not to believe that God exists. It is foolish not to believe that God, there is a higher being that has created all of this. It is foolish. So, the first order of business is you're going to demonstrate faith. That you must believe that God exists. He tells you it's impossible to please him without faith, you know. And he tells you that you must first believe that God exists. And then he says you must seriously search for God. And that he is a rewarder of them which diligently seek him. If you believe that God exists, then the next thing is, Lord, I want to know you. I want to have a relationship with you. I want to have a closer walk with you. I want you in my life. So if you're going to unlock the blessings that you keep praying for, the deliverance, you're going to need to increase your faith, which is what I'm going to talk about over the next couple of weeks, in order to get to this place. So let's look at two examples of stepping out by faith, the demonstration of faith. He starts with Noah and then goes into Abraham. Verse 7. By faith, Noah, being warned of God of things not seen as yet, moved with fear, prepared an ark to the saving of his host. Another word for saving is deliverance. We're not talking eternal salvation. Deliverance of his host. By the which he condemned the world and became heir of the righteousness which is by faith. Noah is the first example. He uses a phrase here, the author uses a phrase here and says, by faith Noah, being warned of God of things not seen as yet. If you're going to step out by faith, there are going to be some things that you don't see. There are going to be some things that you don't know. There are going to be some places that God has not told you where you're going, but he says, go. By faith, Noah stepped out into the unknown. Out of things he has not seen yet. Can I just remind some of us who may know this already, or others who are just thinking about it for the first time? Things he has not seen yet. Like what? Really? And the first time, really? How far, you know? This is early Genesis. So Some people don't even know that rain didn't fall before. That never needs to have rainfall. All you used to do, that whatever work, you know, all you used to do just make the water come up like you and water the plant them. They never had rain before. So when God says, Noah, build a big boat, because I went in rain, I would suspect that Noah even asked for a definition of what rain is. You see, we know it because we've seen it. Noah may have need some clarification from the instruction God was giving him. Can I tell another thing that he may have not, might have not seen it apart from rain?
Boat.
Big boat, thank you! We said big because we have learned somewhere along the line, something around that sea and lake or water. You understand? So maybe somebody did build a boat before. But not as, but one as big as that. So the first Noah was a big boat, much less he built it. And he has definitely never seen flooding. These are the things that he has not seen yet. But what did he do? He went. The Bible says, I love the afraid. He went moved with fear. Noah acted in reverence and obedience. The word fear doesn't mean reverence, but it's coupled with obedience. When Noah heard, God said, rain will fall. Noah said, we don't know where God is. He acted in reverence and obedience even when he did not have the evidence or the experience. Some of us looking for too much experience.
Amen.
Some of us are not going to move up. Let me come and talk to me a little. Some of us are not going to move if God will tell us certain things enough. Some of us are not going to, we never step up by faith of God. God did an experience for us. What more experience you want? God gave an experience God. There's an experience God. He's your experience. So believe him. And so to step out, Noah says, Lord, don't know what rain is, don't know what flood is, don't know what big word is, but I'm going to step out in obedience, reverence, and I'm going to do this. I have no experience, I have no evidence. That is why you think people don't believe Noah. If some of us were alive in that time, we are telling you, know, some of us may not go for the boat, you know. That is them. And if we were born again, God believing people, some of us were not going to go on that boat because they said, we really go on that boat. In fact, you right to send me telling this. I have no doubt that some of them did things in our mind. And that is why we call it crazy faith. Because sometimes it's not when it looks so, you know, plausible, these nice words. It's not when it looks so logical. Not when it looks so logical. We have to always map out everything. But when God says go, you go. You step out. Then he says, he condemned the world. How does that word, what that phrase all mean? It means that Noah gave credit to God. The world did not. Noah gave God the benefit of the doubt, while the world doubted God. Noah obeyed the world, disobeyed. Noah's faith and obedience exposed the world's doubt and disobedience, thereby condemning themselves. That's what that all means. My friends, if you notice what all this was about, the Bible says in verse 7 that God warned Noah. We need to warn people of the condemnation to come. A state of emergency has been declared on St. James by the government. True?
No.
Listen to this. A state of emergency has been declared by the government. But a state of urgency has been declared by God. We need to warn them. While St. James is in a state of emergency, it means for us that we must get into a state of urgency.
Yes.
It means that more than ever we need to go out here. They are in a state of emergency. The church must get into a state of urgency. Warn them before it is too late. Step out by faith. It doesn't matter where. If God sends you into the most volatile community, let's go. He is the protector, he is the sender, he is the one that is going to take care of everything. Let's go! We have to step out by faith. Oh Lord, let me talk to some of you who are not opening your homes. I'm not going to be judgmental. I'm not going to be judgmental. I will say I understand the state of emergency. And if Sojourn Police tell you to stay in your yard, you stay in your yard. But some people don't get enough. They don't get no easy. They don't get. Oh, let me talk very lovingly. Some people have gotten orders from the Jamaica Constabulary Force, from the Jamaica Defense Force, to stay home. But they say, we're still going to come and free it. Listen, what is the promise of? Why are you going to let me free? Eh? What do you know? They're going to free it, you know? I'm saying that's normal. But I'm saying, God has not given us the spirit of peace to me. Yeah. Let me start over. God has not given us the spirit of fear. But us? I know us? So when you are trying to tell me, so what is the excuse? You got power, you got love, and you got a soul mind. Step out in faith. Come and church in the morning and come and church in the night. Because the doors are open and I'll be here. If you are being restricted, now nah, judge you, understood. But if you have no restrictions, and your restriction is what we call fear, then that is not of God, it's of the devil. That's exactly what the devil wants, to keep us locked in and bottled up like some little coward. Some coward people, and we just don't get it, that we have a powerful God who wants us to do his work. Somebody looks straight for me and I say, what are you? We don't understand what God, of course we understand. But we have to demonstrate faith in God. You have to learn to go out into the unknown. That's the kind of faith. So let's go down to Abraham. In verse 8 to 10, and that's where I'll stop, verse 10. Abraham is the other example of stepping out by faith. By faith, Abraham, when he was called to go into a place which he should after receive for an inheritance, obeyed. And he went out, what? Not knowing whither he went. In other words, he did not know where he was going. God just said, Abraham, your call has come. Take up yourself and your family and go on to a place where I will show you one day. So here is what God does for us. If you are going to step out by faith, when you step out into the unknown, what is going to happen is that you're going to have to depend on God's direction each step you make, because you don't know where you're going. I like it that way, because that way, if he's the director, he's the one that's guiding me, I will not step out of line. I will not go in the wrong direction. So I think, Pastor, God step here for now? Yes. God step here for now? No. All right. Over here, for God. That is living by faith and stepping over by faith. Next?
Yes.
Next? No, right, wait. That's the idea that happened to Abraham. One step at a time, because you never know where I'm going to go. Some of us need too many plans and blueprints. When it comes down to God, the gospel, service, ministry, you are going to have to learn to launch out into the deep. Maybe God is telling some of you right now to launch out into the deep, to start a new ministry, to do something more in this church or do something in Jamaica. And you're saying, Lord, you know where that business you refer on. Give me the proposal. I want to see the proposal. What more proposal do you need? If you have experienced God, believe in him. Abraham did not know where he was going, but he went anyway. Verse 9 and 10 say, by faith he sojourned, he journeyed in the land of promise, as in a strange country, dwelling in tabernacles with Isaac and Jacob, the heirs with him of the same promise. For he looked for a city which hath foundations, whose builder and maker is God. In verse 9, Abraham did not know what he was stepping into, but he stepped out anyway. It says he sojourned in the land of promise as in a strange country, He did not know what he was stepping into, but he stepped out anyway. He didn't know who he was going to meet. There are going to be some things on the way that might be unfavorable, but he says, Lord, I trust you. In verse 10, one thing Abraham knew. He knew God, and that God knew what he was doing. That is why we need to know God. In order to step out by faith, we need to know God. And if we don't know anything else, and if we don't have all the answers, we know that God is never leading us astray.
Amen.
So my friends, I'm going to encourage you. Launch out into the deep, now. Step out by faith. It's all about faith that pleases God. So now you know the definition of faith. Now you know the description of faith. It's time to demonstrate your faith. Now you have received it and you know what's going on. We are going to see how many people are going to demonstrate faith this year and for the rest of your life. Let us pray. Lord, help us. Help us to grasp what faith is. And then help us to understand and exercise it. Lord, I pray that you will lead us. Pray that we will allow ourselves to be led. I pray that you will help those logical thinkers, help the planners, the organizers, those who have been gifted with administration, to realize that there comes a time when you will not reveal the administrative plans, that you will not always have everything seeming logically to human beings, or logical to human beings. But then we are going to need, Lord, I'm an administrator, I'm a planner, and I have to learn that too. So I pray for myself that I will learn to step out by faith and wait. I pray that others will need to learn that, will learn to wait and watch and step one day at a time. Help us to put our entire trust in you, as we know you are indeed over our life and in control of it. You know the future and the plans, interestingly, for the planners. The plans you have for us are not to harm us, but to prosper us and to show us a good end, a good future. So that's all the planning we need, your plans. So God help us to be faithful and trust you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Oh.